My dear students of class 11, how are you? I hope that you are fine by the grace of Almighty God. Dear students, I am Raghunath Boni, Assistant Professor, Department of Statistics, Milestone College. Dear students, today our class number 2 from the chapter 1st, Statistics First Paper. Previous lecture, I discussed the variable and various symbol of the variable. Dear students, today I will discuss the some properties of the variable. Dear students, let's start our class. At first, I will read the theorem 1. If b is a constant and x is a variable, then prove that summation I equal to 1 to n, x I equal to a summation I equal to n, x I. Dear students, proof, let the variable x having n values x1, x2, x3, dot dot xn, and a is a constant. A is a constant, a constant of the a. A is a constant. Sum total of the variable x1, x2 plus x2 plus x3 plus dot dot plus xn. This is the symbol of summation I equal to 1 to n xn. Here I equal to 1 to n. I equal to 1, 2, 3 dot dot n. Okay, dear students, now left hand side summation I equal to 1 to n x I. Putting the value I equal to 1, then the first term is a x 1 from summation plus, and I equal to 2, putting the value I equal to 2, then second term is x 2 in this way plus x 3 plus dot dot plus x n. Here we see that every term has a is common part, a common, that means we have to write x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus dot dot plus xn equal to a summation I equal to 1 to n xn. Right hand side proof. Yes, students, I hope that you have understand the theorem. Another theorem, we have to prove the theorem number 2, just like a is a constant, a and b is constant, a and b are constant, a and b are constant, and x is a variable. Then prove that x I plus b equal to a summation I equal to 1 to n x I plus n b. Okay, dear students, at first we have to write, let the variable x having n values x1, x2, x3 dot dot xn, and a is a constant, and then a x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus xn, we have to write summation I equal to 1 to n xi, I equal to 1 to n. Left hand side, a xi plus b. At first, the first term is, we have to write a x1 plus b, okay? When putting the value I equal to 1, then from summation x plus I equal to, when I equal to 2, then the second term is x2 plus b, when I equal to 3, third term is x3 plus b, in this way, when I equal to n, we have to write xn plus b. Okay, now x term separately we have to write x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus dot dot plus xn plus another b plus b plus b plus dot dot plus b. Okay, now here the common part is a, then we can write x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus dot dot plus xn, and n term b. Okay, so we can write a summation xi I equal to 1 to n plus n b equal to right hand side proof. Okay dear students, now we have to prove that the two variable, now we have to prove theorem 3. If x and y are two variables, then prove that if x and y are two variables variables having n terms observation, having n term observation, then prove that xi plus yj yi equal to xi summation yi. Okay, now we have to prove, let variable x having n values x1, x2, x3, double xn and y having n values and y1, x and y having n values at the time, and y1, y2, y3, dot dot, yn. Okay, now we have to prove that here we have to write and y1 plus y2 plus y3 to the plus yn equal to summation I equal to 1 to n yi. Okay dear students, now left hand side equal to summation I equal to 1 to n xi plus yn. At first first term is x1 plus y1. Okay, when putting the value I equal to 1, then from summation plus, and second term x2 plus y2, similarly third term x3 plus y3, and in this way last term is xn plus yn. Okay, and now we have to write the value x1 plus x2 plus x3 dot dot xn plus y1 plus y2 plus y3 dot dot plus yn. Okay, now we have to write summation I equal to 1 to n xi plus summation I equal to 1 to n yi equal to right hand side. Okay dear students, I hope that you have understood theorem 3. Now we have to prove the theorem 4. Theorem 4, we have to draw two variables but several values, several terms. Now, let have theorem 4, theorem 4. Let x is a variable. Let x x and let x next x is a variable. X is a variable having n terms. Having n terms, terms x1, x2, x3, dot dot xn, and y is a variable. Is a variable having m terms, y1, y2, y3, dot dot yn. Then prove that summation I equal to n, summation j is equal to 1 to m, xi plus yj equal to m summation I equal to 1 to n, xi plus n summation j is equal to 1 to m yj. Okay, dear students, now we will prove the theorem from the two variables. At first, let x is a variable having n terms x1, x2, x3, dot dot xn, and y is a variable m terms, observation y1, y2, y3, dot dot yn. So can write x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus dot dot plus xn equal to summation I equal to 1 to n xn. Okay, and y1 plus y2 plus y3 plus dot dot plus ym equal to summation j is equal to 1 to m yj. Okay, dear students, now we have to draw left hand side equal to summation I equal to 1 to n, summation j is equal to 1 to m, xi plus yj. Okay, at first we draw the value of y term, and x term below we have to fix. Okay, now we can write summation I equal to 1 to n. Draw a term of the j values, y values. First term is xi plus y1. Second term, xi plus y2. Third term, xi plus y3. In this way, the last term is xi plus ym. Okay, now we have to write summation I equal to 1 to n, xi plus dot dot plus xi. That means m terms xi. And we have to draw the m values m times xi, and summation y1 plus y2 plus y3 plus dot dot plus ym. Now we have to write summation I equal to 1 to n m times xi plus summation j is equal to 1 to m yj. Putting the value x terms, then we have to write first term mx1 plus summation j equal to 1 to m yj plus second term mx2 plus summation j equal to 1 to m yj plus third term is mx3 plus summation j equal to 1 to m yj and last term is mxn plus summation j is equal to 1 to m y j. Okay, dear students, now x term is separate. We have to write mx1 plus mx2 plus mx3 dot dot plus mxn and summation j equal to 1 to m yj plus summation j equal to 1 to m yj plus summation j equal to 1 to m yj plus dot 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 plus summation j equal to 1 to m yj. Okay, now here we take the common mx1 plus x2 plus x3 plus dot dot plus xn. Okay, and here n term yj, n term n summation j equal to 1 to m yj. We have to write summation I equal to 1 to n xi plus n summation j equal to 1 to m y j equal to right hand side. Okay, dear students, I hope that you have understand class. If you face any problem, so watch the video again and again. Okay, dear students, thanks to all. Goodbye.